boys and girls, I got some true stories to tell.
I told my boys, it ain't no limit. Told all my dogs, it ain't no limit.
Put your
head in the game, head in the game, head in the game. Head in the game, head in
the
game.
I'm whipping that track, I was messed up suspension. I drove it so fast that I blew out the engine. I kept it 2 mil ever since the beginning. I play offensive D, I might switch my position. Lil mama was thirsty, so I had to quench. I'ma drive real fast, cause you know I shoot quick. Just like Travis Kelsey, I be having emotions. Just like a lamb, I ain't know I'm exploding. My heart cold, bad, I ain't got emotions. I'm going hard, yeah, you know I'm devoted. We running streets, yeah, you know we control it. She love the kids, she be busting it over. I'm quarterbacking like I'm Kyler Murray. Trying to win, I'm up at practice early.
It's another one. We got another one. It's her. Who that? Big baby slide through in that drop top. Something by Benz looking cute. That's honest. Her and her friends. Big blinks and snatch waist. Yeah, she brought the. Ain't no way somebody daddy ain't gonna give her the spins with her ends. Cause yeah, she did it. She did it again. A few more tracks and this time she bought friends. Big baby on her way.
Want the heat, you know who to send for your info. Buy my money like Venmo. This music don't work out. Don't know how to get it from my ends low. How you feel though? Cause hey, they can't rock with us. Galaxy ain't no stopping us. They ain't trying to steal my style. I'm feeling like I just shop. Can't trust him cause he numb. Cause we worried about getting figures. All my ain't father figures. Just know my quick to pop it.
Damn, it's the intro? Yes, it's the intro. Damn. Damn, it's the intro? Yes, it's the intro. Damn, this is the intro?
My God, oh God, this is sun and God level. The sun, the sky, you can see the vibe. We ride the high, always on a high level. So open up your eyes better.
Why these tell me? You can join the journey, you is worthy. Just allow me, no. Kicking down your door. Bloodsuckers, I see this industry is filled with sheep. People that pretend to be something that they would never be. Oh my, I just need some little old peace of mind.
The sons of kings, the ghouls, the gods. The moon, the light, the fools, the frogs.
My God, oh God, this is sun and God level. The sun, the sky, you can see the vibe. We ride the high, always on a high level. So open up your eyes, baby.
I can never be controlled. Let them know. 500 helicopters driving me guns out. But they want you just to envy. Let them see it. I'm the first to say it. Now it's time you just believe it. I got too many fakes, made lots of foes. These people close. Talk down your dreams because they know they can't come close. Don't shake no hands, they'll steal your friends. I walk alone. I see false idols. The titles you need to grow.
Have you lost your mind?
But I ain't like the others no more. God, I'm learning lessons as I go.
You're only wasting time.
Tell the devil there's a door. Praying God is only trying to test me for the
throne.
Day. From U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis, it's Week the NFL on EA Sports.
Minnesota standards, but then again, it is still summer. Either way, the AC is working just fine at U.S. Bank Stadium in the Twin Cities. Today, we kick off the new year with an NFC North matchup between the Green Bay Packers and the Minnesota Vikings. Joined by Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden, and it is finally time to kick off another NFL regular season, folks. Here we go, and what a game we have to start, Charles. A rivalry showdown between the Packers and the Vikings, two teams who have really defined the NFC North for some time.
So let's face it, fans in Detroit, fans in Chicago don't want to hear it, but you nailed it, because one of these two has won 13 of the last 15 NFC North titles in Green Bay. They're on a three-year streak with 13 wins in each of those seasons. The Packers are obviously heavy favorites, but if Minnesota can get above its 8 wins from last year, they've got a chance to challenge Green Bay for this division crown.
And here comes the winner of the last two NFL MVP awards, Aaron Rodgers, as he brings his Packers out for their first series of the game.
Even as he nears age 40, Aaron Rodgers' game isn't taking a single backward step. He became only the fourth player to win back-to-back MVP awards and led Green Bay to its third straight 13-win season.
They'll try and run for it with Jones. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. A nice job defensively. And it likely forces a punt situation on fourth. So opening drive, three straight runs, unable to pick up the first.
I know the fans want to see first downs, but guess what? The coaches have reasons for what they're doing. Sometimes they've scripted it. And some of these runs, while they haven't been successful now, they may be successful later on.
And here's Hoffrichter now, the punter, as he sends this one away. And the fair catch is made at about the 27-yard line. Yeah, call it 38 yards on the punt, no return. So here's the Viking offense making their way out. And they will be led out by a young man, probably with some butterflies here. A lot of anticipation making his first NFL start.
For every rookie prospect, there are always nerves involved in this moment, running your team out to start a game. But there's a reason they brought him in. We're willing to make him their starter today. They believe he can overcome those nerves and lead his team to a victory. We saw him do it at the collegiate level and really make himself into a leader and someone you can envision doing the exact same thing here in the NFL.
Kenny Clark, the big D tackle there to make the stop. The last run got three. Now here's second and 7. Again, it's Cook. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. He'll get 15 and a Vikings first down.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run. And let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
Following the good run by Cook, here's another first and 10. Operating from the gun, Rich. Swinging this out wide here for Cook. And they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47. 3 yards to go on second down, and they've got three tight ends out there. Jumbo set. That's complete to Justin Jefferson. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers' 25-yard line. 23 yards the pickup there.
I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere, and they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well, and that's what they just did on that play.
Now a play fake here on first down. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. It'll be a loss of 10. And it'll bring up second.
But you just knew that these rushers were eager to do that today. Put him on the ground. Their plan? Introduce themselves individually to this rookie quarterback. They said hello in a big way there with a loss of double-digit yards on that sack.
So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. Back to throw. Rich, catch is made by Hockenson, the tight end. And they'll work this down inside the 30. Throwing on third and long. Rich, and this is going to be incomplete. Now Greg Joseph for the field goal try. From the left hash, this from 46. Joseph's got it, and the Vikings have a 3-0 lead. So pretty good opening drive. That'll make the home fans somewhat happy. They wanted six, but they got three in the early lead.
And they should be happy. The guys look good getting down the field. That's got to give them a little bit of hope that good things are in store here today for them.
And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. Packers offense here coming back out for their second drive. And Charles, nothing like squaring off with a division opponent, a division rival in week one. Do you like that they are matching up this early, or would you prefer a game like this be a few weeks down the road?
I actually like the early matchup for a few reasons, Brandon. First of all, it allows you to see that in the entire offseason and know, hey, right out of the gate, we're playing a division game. Second part is it spreads them out a little bit. If you just have them all bunched up at the end of the year, that's not as much fun watching teams try to survive that gauntlet when you do have injuries down the stretch. And last but not least, let's face it, we're TV people. What a great game to sell right out of the gate.
On second down, it's Jones. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. The Vikings here hosting Green Bay in the season opener, and they've got one of those quirks in the schedule that is going to work in their favor. They play all three of their division home games in the first 5 weeks of the year. After Green Bay today, they'll host Detroit in week 3 and then Chicago in week 5.
And decided to run a hitch route. It really helped to have a guy who can turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
Ball at the 40 here for second and 5. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. And good running there as he'll take this all the way up to midfield. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here.
Coming in, he really liked his chance of having a big year based on a terrific offseason. And runs like that on opening weekend show that he's right.
And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. And he'll just plow right into a host of tacklers. Nothing there at all, and it'll be second and 10. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. From midfield, here's Rodgers. And he's going to be taken down right at the 40-yard line. This will be play number 7 on the drive, 3rd and 1 yard. Now Rodgers. Pass caught, it's Romeo Doubs. And he is going to have a Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
Off the play fake to Jones. Here's Rodgers. Completes it again to Dobbs. And he'll be marked down right at the 15-yard line.
Dobbs made to day three of the draft, and Green Bay loves the dimension he brings to their group of receivers, and that's speed. The head coach really wanted someone who could take the top off of the defense in the draft, and they got him in Romeo Dobbs out of Nevada. You can easily see him getting steadily more and more targets as the weeks go on.
A first red zone opportunity of the new year here as they come up now first and 10. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. Rodgers to throw once more. Yeah, he's got it. And the Packers are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line.
And coming into this ball game, this was an offense that wasn't just talking about the notion of ball control. They were preaching it. They want to win the time of possession battle, and they've done so here. This drive's taken up quite a bit of the first quarter. Now they are set up first and goal.
They'll go again from the three here on second and goal. Jones will score. Touchdown, Packers. Well, he finishes off the drive with a touchdown run, Charles. Remember, he also had a catch on this drive as well.
And that's what running backs want to be in today's NFL, a complete back. Three downs, stay on the field, run it and catch it, and he gets it done.
Brian Johnson now for the extra point. One for one on the new year as his kick is good. That one in the books as a 12-play drive. And the last play in the drive was a touchdown run by Aaron Jones. Here's Johnson set and ready to kick this one away. Taken at the goal line. And he won't quite make it to the 25. The Vikings taking the field here for their second drive of the game. They finished off their opening drive of the campaign with a field goal on the last drive. Now they'll search for a touchdown here on this go-around, first and 10. Throwing to start the drive. Rich, flush to his right. Oh, good move. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
I haven't met a quarterback yet that didn't enter the league with a massive chip on his shoulder if he wasn't a first-round pick. They want to show the league that they made a big mistake. Determined to get the first down there, no hesitation at all to tuck it and go. I bet he would have tried running through their entire defense if it meant reaching that marker.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10, just outside the 30. Looking to throw. Rich, Justin Jefferson bringing in the slam. And he'll be marked down right at the 20-yard line. They had to settle for three last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in six. In good position, first and 10. And they're going to get this down inside the 15.
I think the defense surprised him there with that blitz on first down, but give him credit. Stayed cool under pressure and still found a way through the extra rushers for positive yardage. Well done.
On second down, Cook. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first and goal. His first carry of their second drive, pretty solid. And, of course, remember back to their first drive, really strong throughout that one.
Not only is he getting good blocking up front, but how about his vision to find the holes? And he's seeing things before they even open and hurtling through them.
A chance for a first touchdown drive of the year. It's first and goal. Cook, he is going nowhere in a hurry as he is going to lose yardage here in a big way. He lost six there on the first down play.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft and able to really make a big time play for their defense.
Now from the seven, here's second and goal. Running the jet sweep, this is Thielen with it. And he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. Maybe the first big test of the season here on both sides. This is third and goal. It's caught in the end zone, touchdown Minnesota. T.J. Hockenson, a 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Vikings are able to move back in front. Well, with this rookie QB, we talk a lot about his ball placement and how good he can be at laying it right in there. I think we just saw, Charles, though, the strength of that arm. That was an absolute rifle for the completed touchdown.
It absolutely was, and let's face it, you think he was really ready to get that first touchdown? Absolutely. He threw that pass with authority, just as you described. Big-time arm right there, and let's face it, a lot of quarterbacks used to be pitchers in baseball. The fastball was usually their best pitch, and we saw it there.
Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. Keyshawn Nixon now from his end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. The Packers offense now heading back out onto the field. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways because you know they're both motivated. They both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Rodgers again here on second and 10. They find some open field here.
Well, this had trouble written all over from the start. He's got two extra defensive backs in the game he's got to deal with. They're in a dime set. So everywhere he's looking, he's seeing a different color jersey. And sure enough, this one winds up being intercepted.
Minnesota's offense takes over possession. Following the interception, they're set up nicely here, already inside the red zone, knocking on the door, if you will, first and 10. Throwing on first down. Rich, right side, it's the tight end, Hockenson. Call it a gain of six on the play, and it'll be second down. They'll try the wide side with Cook. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop him right around the one. Heavy set out there on third and one. They'll run it. Here's Cook. And he will score. Touchdown, Vikings. Dalvin Cook taking it in from a yard out. And they're able to add on to their advantage. On third down and short, and everything well executed. He not only gets the first down, Charles, he gets the touchdown as well.
And you see the defense commit to the run so often in these situations. There's always that little bit of hesitancy, isn't there, partner? Thinking that they may play action you? They took advantage of that hesitancy and found their way into the end zone with a running play.
Joseph now to have the PAT. It's good to make it 17-7.
The drive there only spanning three plays. And it's capped off by the touchdown run coming from Dalvin Cook.
Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. Taken in at the three. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26. The Packers offense set to go. As the offense comes out here, Charles, maybe perhaps a bit more of a focus on the run game for this drive after tossing an interception on the previous one?
I think that's a good way to look at it and a good way to think about it, but maybe they get to it in a little bit different way, because after you throw an interception, you want to make sure you keep your quarterback's confidence high. So maybe give him a couple easy throws that he can complete and then get to the running game and try and get things settled down.
Yeah, and still in the first half here, a long way to go. Off the option, it's Jones.
And he'll be taken down, as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play.
After one, 17-7 is our score.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And he's got it across the midfield stripe and into Viking territory.
The last run got six, now second and four.
Rodgers now to throw.
Slant route, he's got Dobbs.
And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings 36. Play action, now it's Rodgers. The Vikings after him, and they get there for the sack.
And Danielle Hunter, he's the one who gets in there and brings him down to the ground.
It was great just to see Danielle Hunter back on the field after missing all of 2020 with a neck injury. When he's on top of his game, book him for the Pro Bowl, and he'll always be contending for All-Pro status.
So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Another try after the first down sack. Rodgers.
And they're going to work this down to about the 32-yard line.
Doesn't matter whether it's a zone coverage or a man coverage, the drag route can be effective when it's run well.
Seventh play of the drive upcoming here on third and six. Here's Rodgers.
A throw complete to the tight end, Tonyan.
And he is going to have a Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
That was a route run not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
First and 10, here's Rodgers. He'll find Lazard here over the middle.
And he'll be marked down right at the 15-yard line.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
To throw again on second down. Rodgers.
All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Chandon Sullivan.
He's at the 40, 20, 10, and he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. The mistakes continuing to pile up, and it looked like they were going to be able to eat into that deficit. Instead, now the deficit is even larger.
Yeah, they were on a march with a chance to get back within a score, but now that deficit continues to grow.
Joseph on for the extra point. That'll make this a three-score game as the lead moves to 17. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. This will be fielded inside the five. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. We'll remind you that coming up tonight, the first Sunday nighter of the new season. And how about this for a matchup? The Buccaneers and the Cowboys from Dallas, 8:20 Eastern. Then tomorrow, Monday night, just one game here in week one this year. And it'll pit the Broncos and Seahawks as Russell Wilson makes his Bronco debut. And of course, where is it? Seattle. Coincidence? We'll let you decide.
That's a nice job there, because you've got to play the ball, not the man, when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties, and he's able to knock that one away.
They fake the give. Now Rodgers. And a high throw there as this is knocked away, down to the ground and incomplete. The offense on third down, they've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
Pass interference, Ethan.
So the PI decline, and that'll give him a fresh set of downs.
And when you scout tight ends, one thing you want to know, just how strong they are. And we saw it in evidence there. He was able to fight through all the contact and still secure the football.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right at a yard. Again, it's Jones. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Up the middle, Jones. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. On 2nd down, Dillon. And he's going to be stopped just short of the first down marker at the Vikings 31. They're trying to keep the drive going. This will be play number 8. It's 3rd and 2. To throw is Rodgers. And Rodgers intercepted a third time. Picked off by the linebacker Jordan Hicks. Past the 20. And the Vikings are going to take possession of the football. He had his eyes on the end zone. He got close. At least he set the offense up nicely, but he's probably mad he didn't take that one to pay dirt.
I agree with you. And you know he's going to get teased because he didn't get it all the way into the end zone. But if they don't score now, if they don't get a touchdown, he won't just get teased. They'll be glaring at him. How'd you not score?
Suddenly, it's 1st and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. They'll run with Cook. And he's going to get him about 3 yards closer. He's down to about the 2. From the 2 now, 2nd and goal. Again, it's Cook. But he will go backwards as he stopped for a loss. That's going to go down as a loss of 5, and it brings up 3rd down.
And that's what I'd like to see out of this defense, a little fire, a little toughness. It hasn't been the best first half for them, but they did do a nice job there, forcing a loss on that play.
Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is 3rd and goal. Back to throw. Rich. Flushed out. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Sacked by Andrew Van Ginkle.
Well, that's the 2nd time he's been sacked so far in the first half. And if they have designs on having a big year, on going anywhere, they've got to find a way to keep him upright so they can throw the football.
Here's Greg Joseph now to try the field goal. It'll be from the right hash, and it'll be a 36-yarder. The kick by Joseph is good, and that will extend their lead even further. So the interception set him up with terrific field position, but 3 points, the end result.
Yeah, we can make this one pretty simple, partner. You always want to end drives with points, but that's one that you're going to look back on and probably say, we should have done better there.
Nixon elects not to return it, and this comes out to the 25. Another drive coming up for this Packers offense. As the offense comes out here, Charles, remember they threw the interception last time out, but they were moving the football down the field. Looked like they were going to have a sustained drive that ended in points, but then the pick ensued.
And because of that, there's no way you can call the last drive a success. Yes, there are things to build on because they found some play calls at work. Now, they've got to build another drive and find a way to avoid the turnover the plague did on the last one.
Yeah, another negative play in an early down situation. This one to start the drive. You're putting a lot of pressure on your quarterback to bail you out when you're in second and long yardage.
A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. To throw, it's Rodgers. That's complete to Lazard. An extra defender in the secondary for the Vikings here on third down. Now it's Rodgers. Able to find Lazard. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. Rodgers teaming up with Lazard there for a Packer first down. They're going to look to throw. He'll get this to Lazard. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. A couple of first downs on the drive already as they'll go from the 47 now on first down. Again, they'll throw with Rodgers. They'll complete this one to Watson. And they're able to work this across midfield to the 48. An inside give to Jones. And they'll get this just to the 47. 1 yard gain. But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Mark that down for a win in the defense's column.
Seventh play of the drive now as they come up on a 3rd and 3. Rodgers gonna throw. This one complete to Tonyan underneath. And he is going to have a Packers first down by about a yard. It's a gain of 5 on 3rd and 4.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then of course they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play. And that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
Rodgers now on first down. He'll go right back to Tonyan. And finally down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. It's a gain of 34.
I'm pretty sure any quarterback will tell you it's nice to have a tight end that can stretch the field. And how about him right there working in the heart of the defense, and they connect on a very nice play downfield. A combination of talent and toughness to go into the Briar Patch.
Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's 1st and goal just outside the 5. Now Jones. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Aaron Jones. Already his 2nd touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Packers are able to make some inroads here to that deficit. So his strong first half continues as he finds the end zone here for the 2nd time.
And definitely good blocking at the point of attack, and you just have to love watching the way he can create space down near the goal line, and he's able to take it into the end zone.
And Johnson's extra point up and good, and that cuts this lead down to 13. A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all. And the last play in the drive was a touchdown run by Aaron Jones.
Here's Johnson set and ready to kick this one away. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. And out now come the Vikings. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Yeah, run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, second and 10 from the 25. Off the bootleg, Rich. Complete, Jefferson the target. And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. To throw on third down. Rich steps away to his left, and he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. Give him seven on the tuck and run, and it'll get him a new set of downs.
No shortage of impressive moments for him thus far. Now he's halfway to the century mark, and we're still in the first half. There's been no answer for his running ability so far by the defense. I can't wait to see what adjustments they'll have to make during the halftime break.
This offense in midseason form here in the opener. It's first and 10. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. A reminder coming up here at halftime, we'll ship you off to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman will have first half highlights and analysis from a back and forth first half that we've seen. And that's good for a gain of six, and that'll bring up second down. Looking to throw. Rich, open man. He's got Jefferson across the formation. And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line. On first down, Rich on the move past the 40. And he's going to be taken down just shy of the 35. The Vikings going to signal for their first of their timeouts, as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Again, he'll drop to throw. But going back to the same well, it's Hockenson again. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw.
Middle of the field to Jefferson.
And he's brought down inside the 20 at the 18-yard line. Back to throw again. He'll find Thielen working the middle. And the Vikings are going to have a first and goal as he's taken down at about the 8-yard line. Now a signal and a timeout call as it comes with 9 seconds to go in this first half of play. A chance to really cap off a big first half here as they come up on first and goal. They'll look to throw again. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down. Joseph's got it. And that will extend their lead even further. So he's been a busy man here in this first half. That's 3 field goals for him now.
And not just 3 field goals, but 3 for 3. So even though the offense has struggled a bit putting it in the end zone, he's still been able to come away with points due to his leg.
So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend. As we'll send you down to Orlando, and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome back to football, everybody. We've got a full slate of 16 games here to start the new season. So let's take our first trip around the NFL. We'll get our tour started out at venerable Soldier Field in Chicago, where it was the visiting Niners who are able to come away with the road victory. Christian McCaffrey a touchdown run in the victory. From there, we head down to Tennessee to check on the Titans at home in Nashville. And in that one, it's the visiting Giants who have the lead. Saquon Barkley, the lone touchdown there as he's cashed one in on the ground. Lastly, let's motor up to the Motor City. See what's happening with the Lions at home at Ford Field. And things didn't work out for them as they fall to the visiting Philadelphia Eagles. Miles Sanders, two touchdown runs to lead the way. Meanwhile, in our game, no shortage of offense as each team has been able to move the ball effectively. Will the defenses show up in the second half? To find out, we give it back to our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.